Well, Portugal's Nazaré is home to some of the world's biggest and most dangerous waves. And over the weekend, Aussie surfer Matt Formston conquered the famous break by riding a 12-metre monster. And what's extra amazing is he managed it with just 3% vision, having lost most of his sight by the time he was 5 years old. We thought we'd check in with the Aussie legend to see how he pulled off this massive feat. Matt joins us. Please welcome him. Matt, hello, welcome. You're in one piece. How did it feel nailing this?
Amazing, yeah. I mean, you work really hard to do big things and when they come together, it's not a surprise to me. I've done a few different things in my life that have been big tasks, but this one was particularly special and I'm glad. Well, I'm happy. I know my wife and my kids are very happy that I'm coming home in one piece.
Well, Matt, we've heard a little bit about your story. When you are riding one of these waves, what can you see and then what can you feel?
So I can't see anything when I'm surfing a wave. I'm on a big wave, like the waves I was surfing in Nazaré were sort of between 20 and 50 foot.
Yeah.
I was letting go of the tow rope at around 50 to 60 kilometres an hour, so I couldn't see anything. I was just all feel.
Wow.
But, you know, normally I've got 1% vision in my left eye and 3% in my right eye, but that becomes zero at that speed. So I was just feeling the wave, the way I surf every day. I've been surfing for 30 years and I just feel the wave. My front foot becomes my cane. On land, I use a cane in the ocean. I just feel what my surfboard's doing with my front foot, and that's how I feel the wave.
Matt, many surfers turn up to a break and say, no, not today, it's too big. I mean, it doesn't get any bigger than this wave. You had to rely on your crew to describe it to you. What did they say?
We didn't even go that far. Like, I just trusted them. Like, I was the best guys in the world. I had Dylan Longbottom and Lucas Chumbo. They're some of the best big wave surfers in the world. They know my capability. And as a team, we'd already sort of worked out what we could and couldn't do. And it was just up to them to decide on the day whether I could or couldn't surf that day. Because to me, you know, you're right. Most surfers can still look at from the headland at Nazaré and look out and say, no, I'm not into that, or it's beyond my capability. I can't do that. And I couldn't even do that when I let go of the rope. I can't see down the wave and I let go of the rope. I only found out how big the wave was when I, you know, got to the bottom of the wave.
This is extraordinary effort. And I have to say, Matt, it wouldn't take a keen observer to recognise that you and I are quite different people in what we are prepared to have a crack at. But I've seen these waves in documentaries, right? And I look at them and I'm just terrified. Is there a sense in which it actually might be a good thing for you that you can't be terrified in that way, that you don't see them and so you just throw yourself into it?
Absolutely, yeah. The boys have said for years when we pull up at the car park that it's a good thing that I can't see the waves because I wouldn't go out if I could see them. So, absolutely, yeah, there's a benefit to it. And even, you know, surfing the waves, it didn't feel that big. I kept saying, let's go bigger. And, you know, we got to that sort of 50-foot range and the boys were like, no, we're done, Matty, you don't need to go any bigger. Because they could see how big it was, and even the photographers that were filming off jet skis in front of it, they were terrified. They're like, mate, yeah, it's enough. So, yeah, it felt really nice.
Given your lack of vision, Matt, what would have happened if you'd come off?
Same thing that would happen if you fell off. I just go underwater, and I trained for, you know, I've trained my whole life to be as an athlete, and specifically over the last 12 months, I trained to surf this wave. In the gym physically so that my body was able to withstand, you know, the pressures that your body goes under when you cop a beating from a wave of that size. But more importantly, my breath training. So I was in the pool a lot and doing breath training every day. And I, you know, just before we got to Nazaré, I did a personal best breath hold of 5 minutes and 40 seconds.
Wow.
Which is more than like Dylan Longbottom, who's, you know, he won the at Chopu, Code Red, you know, Swell, one of the best big wave surfers in the world. My coach said my breath capacity is better than him. So I'm blind, you know, but the rest of me works fine.
Oh, you've got advantages in other ways too. That's extraordinary that you've got that capacity. Is there anything you wouldn't have a crack at? Or is like that hoodie that you're wearing a preemptive answer to any idea that anybody might have for you?
It depends. It comes down to time for me these days. Back in the, you know, when I was a teenager, absolutely everything was, I wanted to do everything and I still want to do everything, but it's just time. I'd say tennis is a bad thing. I think every time I play tennis, the ball hits me in the balls and it's like, it's a little ball. and that's a little area, but somehow they just find each other every time. So, you know.
Wait. It's not, you're on TV, it's not a little area. Don't call it a little area, Matt.
National platform, Matt.
Mate, you are incredible. You're a Paralympian, a world record holder, World Cup gold medalist in tandem cycling, and now a world champion surfer. And you've said that this is the pinnacle of your career. Why is that? Why this?
I just think it's so much. There's so much going on with it. You know, most sighted people wouldn't, that surfers, like, you know, even professional surfers, you know, my friends that are, you know, they won't surf that wave. It's a significantly intimidating thing, and that there is significant risk. You know, death is a reality at that wave. So to be able to pull it off with, you know, with my vision, and not just pull it off, like, people go there to get the Instagram photo, you know, like, I surfed Nazaré and they got the photo, but then they got run over by a train. Like, I surfed, you know, nearly 30 waves there, and I made 29 of them, and I got rolled by one wave. So I didn't just go there and get the Instagram photo. I surfed that wave, and I did it quite well. From what people are saying, so I'm very proud of that achievement.
Oh, Matt, it's an extraordinary feat, and if you want to follow Matt's adventures, his documentary The Blind Sea is out next year. It's also something to think that a tennis court might be scarier for you than these swells. Thank you so much for joining us.
Cheers, guys. Thanks for having me.